and the fire shall try every man work of what sort it is. He said you talking about work, right? If any man's work abide, which means remain, right? Which he had built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. So whatever remain after the fire gets to it, and think, that's my reward. I get a reward. You know Jesus Christ saved us. The Bible calls us God's workmanship, right? Saved us so that we can do good works. Good works. Not bad works. Don't have bad fruit, but good fruit. Good works and stuff, right? That's what we were saved for, right? So now, he's going to try us by this fire to find out if we're doing what he's told us to do. I told you, you ain't got to worry about nobody else. You got to worry about nobody else. It says, if any man work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss. All the evangelism, all the teaching, all the preaching, all of was a miracle working, all the reading of the scriptures, all the rolling around on the floor, all the speaking in tongues. I mean, that don't, I don't even go by that no more. I used to go by that big time. Oh, that's big tongue. I don't even go by that no more. Okay. It said the fruit of the Spirit is.
Come on.
So I look at the fruit now. To everybody speaking tongue now. Because people be marketing it and saying the same thing somebody else is saying. I said the same thing in that church, somebody else saying another church. I mean, they're saying the same thing. So I look at the fruit now. Peace, having and love. Turn to Galatians, dude. All right. We know what Galatians tells us. We know what we're talking about, the fruit of the Spirit. Fruit of the Spirit. Talks about that there. So, a man's word shall be burned, and he shall suffer loss. Here it is. Let me finish it off. But he himself shall be saved, yet so as by fire. So the individual, they born again. They made it to heaven. But they're going to suffer loss. Now, they're not going to get their reward. Can you imagine this here? Anybody been saved a while? We ain't worried about getting to heaven. We work for our rewards now. Our different crowns and different rewards we're going to get. Here it is. You're going to be in eternity forever. Through all eternity forever. And you can never ever go back and get that reward. All right. Because you got to work it out here on earth right now.
My God.
So throughout all eternity, everybody else with their rewards, they're going to be looking at you over there with nothing. So when it comes time to present our gifts to the Lord Jesus Christ, you ain't got nothing to give to. You ain't got nothing to lay at his feet. You ain't got nothing. Throughout all eternity, and other born again believers be looking like, I thought they was, that was Bishop Sutton, you know, top dog. I mean, you know, the biggest church out there. And you was like, he didn't have no self-control. He didn't. Because you get a certain, you get a certain crown for self-control. He didn't get a pastor's crown. So certain things will let us know certain things throughout all eternity. So how do you make an individual feel throughout all eternity? And they done suffered loss. They done missed out on the reward that God was going to pay them for building upon this foundation, which is Jesus Christ. Not deviating from the word of God. Doing exactly like the apostles taught and things. Why teach something else? The apostles started the church out, preached the same thing that the apostles preached. That's why we call it the apostles' doctrine. We don't deviate from it.
No, we don't.
How did that feel? Throughout all eternity. Think about it now. All eternity. That you don't have your reward at all. That'll be a sad day. The Bible says you don't suffer loss. You ain't a lost person. But I listen to folks, and folks say this right here. If I can just be a doorkeeper in heaven, or if I can just be a janitor and clean up heaven and things, why you just want to be that there? If you're a born-again believer, think of that, you're a born-again believer and got the Spirit of God. God on the inside of you now, and think you ought to be able to do way more than just that death.
All right, now.
God got people to take care of that death. Remember, we the bride of Christ.
Yeah.
We the bride.
Yeah.
Well, he go, we go. You know? So you don't want one side of the bride looking all gone, just draped down, jewelry hanging all off, just look so valuable, and then all of a sudden, what happened? What's wrong with you, worthless? Really, as a born again believer, God loves you so much that he trusts you. Trust you with what? He trusts you with the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible said that we are ambassadors.
Yes.
So he made us ambassadors, each and every last one of us.
Right.
We are an ambassador. And when you work for God, you don't work for free. God said, I'm going to pay you your reward. I'm going to give you your paycheck. You know how you run around and say, nobody don't give me nothing. They don't give me no gas money. They don't give me this here. They don't give me that there. But guess what? God is looking at it. God said, oh yeah. Give me all the money. The check right there because you did what I wanted you to do. Oh yeah, I got to reward. Just hang on in there. I do it to the end. Suffer like a good soldier. Don't you give up. I got your reward right here waiting on you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So when you're hanging your head down and you're feeling low and it looks like everybody else is looking over you, and think all you gotta do is say, Lord, I thank you. Because I know one day I'm going to meet you. And when I meet you, I know that you're a faithful God. And being a faithful God, you're going to give me my reward. You're going to give me what I labor for. I'm going to get paid exactly what I do. Remember now. That scripture's not just talking about you. Don't let a faithful over little. You make rules over much. He's not just talking about here, just on earth right now. He's talking about through out of all eternity. That's what he's talking about. In the turn, what you do now,
that's
what you're going to be doing in eternity. Can God trust you with 10 cities throughout all eternity? 100 cities? Can he put you over a country? I mean, think about it now. Can God trust you with that death? So God said, what I will do is, I will watch what you do now.
All right.
I will watch your work now. I'll see what you're doing. And then when I watch what you're doing, everybody said, well, you're doing a wonderful job. You excellent. You're great. I mean, boy, you awesome and things. And God said, yeah, you look good. Everything is wonderful, but I'm going to put it to the side.
Right.
I'm going to see the motive behind your teaching.
Right.
I'm going to see the motive behind your preaching. I'm going to see the motive behind the way you taught in Sunday school class. I'm going to see the motive behind on the missionary board. I'm going to see the motive behind on the mother's board.
Right.
You know, I'm going to see the motive behind on the youth board and things.
Yeah.
I'm going to see the motive behind anything.
Come on with you.